Hi, Nick Collier here, and this is my shop. Come join me. We'll have some fun.
Good morning, Nick Collier here. It's going to be a summer day today. The next couple of days is supposed to get to 102. Of course, not here in the barn because we're up at 3,000 under the trees, but in town. And I make this little tool here for the jewelry industry. It's called a bench pin, an adjustable bench pin, which is kind of unheard of in that industry. So that you can go up and down and you can turn it one way or the other and get different angles to do filing and sawing for jewelry. Now, this guy shows up the other day. Let me take this down a little bit. This guy shows up the other day and he says, man, I really want this bench pin. In fact, I want two of them. But I do a little bit different kind of thing. He actually makes tattoo guns, fancy ones. And so he says, I put a lot of pressure on the end here because I come in and grind it, everything, and I'm not sure that this wood will hold up to that. And I said, that's okay. He said, can you make me a thicker one? Well, I said, yes, I can. And it certainly ain't as pretty, but it's definitely thicker. Now, as you can see, if you twist this one way or another, it gives you more of an angle, which is part of the plan. It was part of the original plan because there's places where you want it to be down at an angle. Now, the problem is that when you twist it and you're sitting here, this is kind of out of your way. And he says, but what I really want is I want to be able to bring this back around to face me so that I can adjust it horizontally. And I said, let's see what we can do there. And so what I'm going to do is build a platform underneath this thing that allows this to rotate, probably 120 degrees or so. He doesn't need much more than that. So that's what we're going to film today. So hang in there with me. We're going to have a good time.
Okay, well, instead of starting with a tower that's attached to the platform, we're going to just go straight to the platform, and that way we can maneuver it around without having this big tower hanging out in our way. Now, if you look down close, and I'm going to bring you in a little closer. Okay, something like there, and I think you can see it. I sketched a basic design for this adapter plate. And, in reality, what we're going to do is we're going to take and use the same design as a vise that has a rotating head on it. And if you take the vise apart, you see that it has a slot for a T-nut. And so basically that's what we're going to do here, is create a slot for a T-nut and put our this piece on top with a piece in between that has a plug, and the whole thing will rotate. And then one of these holes will have a locking mechanism that will lock into the T-nut. So, and this is a sketch I did last night. I did it in about 5 minutes or 10 minutes maybe. And pretty much this is all you're ever going to get out of me, because I like to do it as I go. I don't like to know exact sizes and numbers. I mean, I'll do it, and I certainly can do it, but it's boring. I like to just kind of wing it and just go in. And sometimes, I totally screw the thing up and I have to throw it away and start again. But that's half the fun of it. So this particular project, we're going to approach it from that method. And, I was looking for, and basically this circle here is right in here. So what I needed is a piece of material that's much wider than that. And I, you know, I looked on eBay and Jesus, they wanted an arm and a leg for crappy metal too. And I happened to be walking around the shop and I happened to look at this piece that I have laying here. And we're gonna bring you up to see it. There's the top. Here's my,
and I think
there's enough room there to come in and put some holes in it so that it can be attached to a table or whatever. So we're going to use this particular piece of metal, unless, of course, we can find another one that's even bigger. But for now, we're looking at this.
All right. Well, I thought about it a while, and I just don't feel comfortable with this little of an edge there. I mean, this bolt's going to just sit barely right there on that edge. That doesn't feel good to me. So I ended up ordering a couple of pieces of 5-inch, when this is 4.5. So it's going to take us out a little bit more. It's going to give us a better edge. And while that's on its way over from Michigan or someplace like that, we're going to go ahead and go in and clean this up and get our plug cut for that and go from there. Let me tighten this up. And if you remember, this is the piece that's going to connect to the base plate.
Okay, so our first piece of material is going to be a piece exactly the same size as the platform, and you know, that's fine. And this piece will have the plug in it, and it will drop down into the bore of this material here. So we've got 1 inch there, and I'm thinking we could have 1 inch here, and that's pretty much going to give us what we want. Now, now it isn't as much room as I was hoping for, and we're going to take this over to the saw, and we're going to cut that 1 inch off of it.
All right, well, I thought about it a while, and I just don't feel comfortable with this little of an edge there. I mean, this bolt's going to just sit barely right there on that edge. That doesn't feel good to me. So I ended up ordering a couple of pieces of 5-inch, when this is 4.5. So it's going to take us out a little bit more. It's going to give us a better edge. And while that's on its way over from Michigan or someplace like that, we're going to go ahead and go in and clean this up and get our plug cut for that and go from there. Let me tighten this up. So. For some reason, this piece is slightly off, so we're going to switch it. We have others. Like they're all maybe what we're going to do is cut ourselves a couple of new pieces. And we'll be back. Okay, Nick Collier here, and we've been waiting, almost 2 weeks for these pieces of steel to show up. We were using, and I'm going to show it to you if I can find it. We were planning on using this size here, but it just wasn't quite big enough. So I went to the next size up, 5 inches. I had the 4.5 laying around, but I went to the 5, and so that's going to give us plenty of room to put an Allen bolt in the center there. So we're going to go ahead and square this surface up and clean up the edge here, and then flip it and do the same thing to the other side, then drill it and set it up, and I'm going to go get that other piece. Set it up so that this can slide smoothly inside of that. And that should do the trick. So, I think we should just get started. What the hell? I mean, I don't like to start before 8 o'clock in the morning because of my neighbors, but it's now 7:30 and my neighbor just cranked up his tractor. So, hey, I guess I can make some noise. And because I have a semi-worn out blade, and I don't know how it's going to act in a big piece of material like this, I think what I'm going to do is give myself 1.25 inches and cut it down. And if it tends to wander off one way or the other, I'll still have material left to play with. So we're going to put a little oil on this. And let's start cranking. Okay, that's much better. We've come in and cut another piece a little bit wider too, just to give us a little bit of room to kind of play around a bit. So we're ready to start turning.
All right, let's flip this over and slide it in here. And we're going to get it in fairly close to the outside edge. In fact, as close as this bolt head is. And that looks pretty good. Let's see how it looks spinning. Not good at all. Better, but not no cigar. Good. I mean, we're just eyeballing this inside edge here to square up this outside edge. I mean, if we were spinning here, but this guy's going to turn it 120 degrees at the max. So there's not a whole reason, a whole lot of reason to be dead nuts accurate. Because what we want is the threads are going to go down that far, so that's going to be plenty. All right, so I'm going to lock my carriage lock into place. And we'll just hand spin our way out of here. Take 20, 40, 60. Let's see what that does. No problem.
Well, as you can see, this bit is not cut evenly because it's hogging out pretty heavy on this side and then it's pretty light on that side, but just a little bit. And I don't care because this bit is hardly ever used for accurate cutting. I'm usually just hogging out a hole to see, you know, to get in there so I can bore it. So yeah, maybe someday I'll go in and square up those edges a bit, but at this point, I don't think so. Okay, we get rid of some of these big chips. And we're ready to bore this thing out, and it'll be a lot smoother and a lot more accurate. And just all around a lot more everything. That's not gonna fit. All right, let's leave that in place. And this is where our smaller head comes in nicely. At least one hopes. Much better. Much, much better. We're going to take our bit out and we're going to come in with a cutoff tool.
chamfer our edges with the cutoff tool. Done deal. Now we got to make the second one, but we'll do offline, and
okay,
we'll
so
be
we've
back.
Got our two pieces cut, number two, so now we want to just square the surface up, and also I want to get them equal in depth. So we're going to create that here.
All right, so we've taken the donut and flipped it, and we're on the back side now, and basically we're going to come in here and relieve this back side a bit so that the we can get a washer in there and get that squared up. All right, we're down to the last few cuts here, and I want to
kind of just square up my bit just a little bit. Just kind of sharpen it up. We're going to go in and across, and we should have it. We need to cut a slot and two holes. Right. Well, no, just a slot. Because the holes are going to go in this, and that's going to hold this down to this, and then the slot will hold this down to this. And I think we're ready. I'm going to just clean up that edge a little bit. As soon as I can find my T-handle. There it is, over where it doesn't belong. All right, so we're going to take this off. And see how it fared. Well, let's get all the grit off of there. And drop it in there, and we've got a perfect rotation. And we're just slightly under, which is, well, we're going to need to cut just a little bit more off of this because I see that this is under that, and we need it to be over this so that it can rotate anytime we want it to. And I'm going to put a pretty good size washer out beyond that so that it holds it in place and yet allows it to rotate. So we can do that at a later date. Sure, this one's going to do it. Yep, just right.
It's about, oh, I don't know, 5 thousandths over the top of that. I can feel it. So that'll give us room to slide and yet still hold it in place. Okay, so we're going to take and put the other sleeve or the other piece of material on here and drill it and do the same thing we just got through doing. So, and you know, we don't need to film the second one. And we'll be back.